Once upon a time, in a land far, far away, a kingdom was prospering. But peace could only last so long. The old king died. With no descendant to the throne, the kingdom fell into chaos. Lust for power blinded warriors and wizards alike. New kings emerged, only to fall the next day. But the madness of men would soon be overshadowed by a far greater evil. The magic that once gave life and good fortune had transformed into something sinister. One by one, grave by grave, the dead began to rise, feeding off the energy that grew stronger with each passing night. Fear spread throughout the kingdom, and it was soon abandoned. On the outskirts of the kingdom, near the Astral Academy, a thief carried out her cunning plan. She had learned of an ancient object of tremendous value. The Astral Academy, left to rot in the face of the terrible enemy, had no one to keep the treasure safe. The time was right. Everything was perfect. She had made her way to the castle and would soon lay her hands on the treasures she so desired. Gentle Moon smiled at the thief as she made her way towards the Shrine of Ancient Treasure. Strangely, the protective charms around the shrine allowed her to enter unharmed.
I got it.
As the thief lay her hand on the treasure, she had a tingling sensation. The thief would soon discover that fate had taken hold of her. Unknown to the thief, a wizard was just waking up. The wizard had taken a look in the spyglass and seen the terrible undead army. He was keen not to die.
By my trousers, I must escape.
He had been studying the stars and trying hard to learn the elusive fireball spell that all wizards ought to know. Of course, that was a lie. For you see, the wizard had a certain reputation with the ladies. What he had really been up to was the creation of a fake fireball potion that would have impressed the ladies and improved his status. The potion had backfired, causing a fortnight of sleep. The wizard saw a glimmering light coming from the shrine. No one had been able to visit it for centuries because of the ancient magic protecting whatever lay inside.
My darling, why the painful look on such a pretty face? What is this object you are holding onto? How did you get here?
The wizard touched the thief's hand, and then the object. His hand got stuck.
What kind of trickery is this?
For once, the wizard was more interested in magic than anything else. He He was also afraid for his dear life. But there was someone nearby who welcomed a challenge. At the other end of the Astral Academy, the knight had been practicing his own skills to battle the undead and prove himself worthy of joining the king's army. Between me and you, he did not quite understand what undead meant, but this was his chance to be the bravest knight of all. The knight felt it was his duty to protect the Astral Academy during this time of despair. He was on the lookout for anything unusual. Faint light coming from the age-old shrine. Could there be a thief? Was this the knight's day of honor? He had sworn an oath to himself to protect the shrine and the academy. Nothing could stand in his way.
What's going on?
The knight joined in, taking a firm grip of the object's third side, in a way that only a mighty warrior can.
Oh no, this doesn't bode well.
What doesn't bode well?
There was a flash of light, and the wizard, the thief, and the knight simply disappeared. Our new heroes were overwhelmed by the effect of the mysterious object. The wizard tried hard to remember everything he'd learned of the shrine and its artifact. His mind raced through ancient tales and legends. Finally, the wizard remembered. The treasure, the ancient object, was a device that could bind souls together. How it worked, he did not know. But he knew that it was connected to the legend of the Guardian, whose earthly remains had been buried in the catacombs deep underneath the Astral Academy. The tomb resided right below the shrine. The wizard could not explain it, but he was sure the object was called the Trine. The knight didn't care. A more pressing concern was on his mind.
Stole the king's treasure!
Did you not understand a word I said? It is not treasure, it's an ancient object, the Trine. I believe it has bound our souls. We are stuck together.
But she...
The thief remained silent. She was waiting for the right moment to escape, hopefully with the treasure and without the pair of fools.
I think I know how we can use the device as we like.
Me. Oh God!
Into. We have to find a way to reverse the spell, to undo the magic. The tomb of the Guardian in the catacomb will have the answer, and it's not far away. Thank you. Oh, that's just great.
They don't like us being here. This looks very nice. Perhaps this journey isn't for nothing. Let's strike a deal. I'll help you find whatever you're looking for, and I get to keep all the jewelry.
I must say, that necklace looks very good on you. It's a deal.
Earhart could not approve of this. Thank you.
What lay ahead of our heroes was unknown. They had not seen another man, woman, or child in ages. The undead had transformed everything. They were now surrounded by evil. But our heroes had to press on. They were in search of the tomb. The wizard was sure that it would belong to the founder of the Astral Academy, one of the three guardians. If they could find his tomb, perhaps they would find a spell to get them out of the trine.
Where are we?
We are beneath the Astral Academy. No one has been here for decades.
Aha! My sword shall lead the way! Follow me!
Yes, you are correct. This is the tomb of the Guardian. It has inscriptions all over it.
As the wizard read the inscriptions, legends of artifacts began to emerge. There had once been three Guardians, each with an artifact to protect. The Trine was an artifact of the soul and righteousness, and a catalyst for the powers of good that had quietly helped raise young, good-hearted wizards in the Astral Academy. The two remaining artifacts were mentioned only briefly. The second artifact that pertained to mind and power had been stored in the great castle in the middle of the kingdom.
It all makes sense now. Our souls are entwined in this artifact, and our physical beings are mere images of our soul.
Oh, I'm getting hungry for all this fighting!
Why don't you listen to me? This is exciting. We must hurry to the castle.
And this is the way. Dragon Graveyard. So instead of small bones, we go where the big one is first. What will we do if they come to life?
It's the fastest way to the castle, my darling. Fast.
Thank you.
Having survived the wasteland of the Dragon Graveyard, our heroes carried on. The wizard delved deeper into the inscriptions about the Guardians. One for the soul and righteousness, one for the mind and power, and one for the body and matter. These immortal objects have been used to balance all good and evil in the world. When everything was in harmony, the artifacts had been given to the three Guardians, who had kept them safe for centuries. The Guardians enchanted the artifacts with powerful protective charms that only allowed those with pure intents to come near them. Eventually, the Guardians passed away, and only the charms remained. The wizard could still not find answers as to why they had been captured in the Trine, and how they had been able to go unharmed by the protective charms.
Thank you.
Place in our heroes' hearts. Deeply troubled, their minds began to fill with woe. The knight had not eaten in many hours, and the scent of meat had not made it any easier. The thief started to worry if she would ever be free again. And the wizard, well, he was concerned that they would never find the other artifacts to break the trine's spell. The truth be told, he didn't mind having some company that stuck with him for more than an hour.
Fear not! I shall lead the way! I wish there was more light.
Is unbearable.
I've seen wizards light torches with fireballs. Can you?
But fireballs? They never work. It's a waste of time.
I should have known. I can light the torches with fireballs.
I could light the torches too!
We have to get out of here.
We're close to the dungeons. This is the way to the castle.
Ah! The castle! On to the castle!
Heroes entered the castle through the dungeons. The knight thought back to his childhood days and the excitement the dark corridors had provided, back when the spiders were small and the bones were piled neatly in the corners.
This place gives me the chills.
It's a dungeon. That's what it's supposed to be.
Fear not. I have my sword and my tank. I am the king of the castle. I shall crush all my enemies and lead my army to victory. We are invincible!
Thank you.
king's banner. The symbol looks like the artifact we're looking for.
What are these artifacts anyway?
The second artifact, that of mind and power, had protected the castle and given strength to the king and his men. But the artifact was also protected by powerful charms, and only minds with pure thoughts could touch it. Over the decades, many kings and knights had tried to approach the artifact, to no avail. The legend foretold that one day, a hero of pure mind and justified intent would come and claim the artifact. But as our heroes came through the castle door, they realized that the undead had seized everything in the castle. This once magnificent place had been transformed into a place of terror.
This doesn't look like the castle I've heard of.
He believes.
They have ruined it all!
We must hurry.
Oh!
Look over there. What's that? Some sort of book.
Yes. I'll have a closer look.
With great enthusiasm, the wizard absorbed the contents of the king's journal. Of particular interest were the last pages. The king told of how they had found the ancient ruins, abandoned long ago. Statues of virtue and architecture beyond imagination had clearly impressed the old king. The king's journal did not contain much on the artifacts, but the vivid descriptions matched the signs on the tomb of the first guardian. In legend, there exists a place that the guardians had called their home. If this was true, and the ruins were the origin of the artifacts, our heroes might finally get some answers. The journal had carefully mapped out the location of the ruins. It was in the middle of the forest, a long distance away. Our heroes began to follow the directions in the king's journal. At the edge of the forest, the thief felt a strange sensation, a warm feeling in her heart.
We've a long way to go if we want to reach the ruins before nightfall.
It's so calm here.
I feel like a boulder has lifted from my shoulders.
Thank you.
Night came so very fast, ushered by the forces of evil. It was only a matter of time before the inevitable would happen, but for now, the forest stood strong against the invaders, perhaps because the artifacts had been created nearby. There was hope yet.
Are we finally getting somewhere? I don't like all this darkness.
Ah! Thank you.
Finally, the darkness subsided, and our heroes were relieved to find themselves in the light again. The thief quietly surveyed her new surroundings. She had never been here before, but for reasons beyond explanation, she felt a sense of belonging. The ruins of the perished, as the old king had called them, looked exactly as described in the journal. Beautiful and majestic, despite the centuries gone by. The third artifact could perhaps be found at the highest location of the ruins.
These are ancient ruins. I don't think anyone's been here for a while.
Except those nasty bones!
Who would abandon something like this? It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Paul!
empty. It's not here.
Just a guardian at rest.
Not too long ago, an earthquake had rocked the pedestal, destroying the shrine that surrounded the artifact of body and matter. The charms that had protected the third artifact broke, and it was stolen. Even worse, it was paired with the artifact of mind and power. Without the artifact of soul and righteousness, the power of the artifacts became twisted and brought to life creatures of bones and dust, capable of moving, but lacking soul and meaning. The trine was the only thing that could bring back balance to the world.
Oh! All this jumping around is not for grown men. I wish I could rest. down!
Heroes looked west, they could see darkness. Where nothing had been before, there now stood a dark tower, black, even against the evening sky. An evil tower. Our heroes understood what they must do. The only way to purge the land of corruption and raise the black tower to the ground was to bring the trine and the other artifacts together. However, for the power to work, the hearts of our heroes must be pure. Despite ever-present danger, our heroes could not help but marvel at the beautiful village. How could anything this beautiful endure so close to the evil tower? Abandoned, there was no one to welcome them.
A village! We must save the people!
They're not here anymore. There's no one to save.
Or crushed bones. It don't matter. Let me go first.
Thank you.
smells are more foul with each step. We must be close to the tower now.
Our heroes broke through the gates of the evil tower and entered the forge, where the undead prepared their weapons and armor. Looking down on them, the evil tower stood tall and menacing. This was the heart of evil.
Oh, this is not good.
This spell reminds me of weapon forging. Ha! I have the best weapon of all!
Thank you.
climb the tower.
I have a bad feeling about this.
As our heroes climbed the stairs, a terrible coldness chilled them to the bone, and the sounds of the forge faded. It was quiet. Too quiet. And then, they heard the voice.
Oh, this doesn't feel good at all.
Quickly, jump to the ledge.
We must get to the top.
As the evil vanished, the old king, or what little remained of his human soul, was set free. The artifact slowly restored the balance of the world. Life and its joys returned to the kingdom. In the spring, a new king was elected. The new king offered rewards to our heroes. The knight refused to become the captain of the king's men. Instead, he finally followed his father's hopes and acknowledged his other passion, that of food and ale. He became the king's royal ale provider. The thief was offered riches beyond her wildest dreams, but she felt a longing to go back to the forest ruins. The king granted her wish and gave her reign over the forest, where life slowly returned, restoring it to its former splendor. As for the wizard, he finally understood that the road to success did not have anything to do with the fireball spell. He wasn't sure what it was, but saving the kingdom certainly helped. After being married a few years to a lady named Margaret, she gave birth to triplets. A charmed moment, many said. We also do not know whether the father felt pride, shame, or both, when each of his children mastered the fireball before the age of one. Despite everything, they all lived happily ever after.